Bass solos must be banned. Banned. At least that's what I read in the papers. Well, it was a while back. It was in Seattle. It was in the op-ed pages. A guy wrote a letter in saying, bass solos must be banned. He was a nuclear particle physicist, you see. He loved jazz, but he got confused during bass solos. And it finally drove him nuts. To the point that the Seattle papers, tongue-in-cheek, of course, printed the letter, but I didn't think it was so funny. You see, when the blues started, the guy could understand it simply because he really knew where the bass was going. So if the trumpet got nuts, he just listened to the bass, he knew where he was, he loved it all, he was happy. Even to the really kind of nutty solos, the guy could follow it because the bass line was right there. We've all heard this kind of solos. He didn't mind as long as the bass was there. Only trouble he had was... He claimed that the bass player was getting lost in the middle of his solos and that no one would admit it. Oh, what a thing to say. Well, of course, bass players were dropping beats here and there. And I understand. And it became like the emperor's clothes. Nobody would say anything. And the bass player would then look up at the end of a solo and go, now? And everybody'd say, oh, yeah, I was right there. You know, all right, that happened. That happened. That happened.